What's up, guys? It's Kay Bowie. On the way to the gym, I'm going to be doing a squat and deadlift workout today. And thank you for coming along with my journey so far, even though it's been, you know, very staggered in the releasing of content. And thank you again to Johnny Candido for giving me a shout out. I know it's a bit overdue, but yeah, I really appreciate that. Been following him since I pretty much started powerlifting. And I've spoken to him on occasion. But yeah, life has been very chaotic these days, and that's why I haven't been releasing content. And it's not that I don't want to, it's that I just don't have the time to these days. But things have been going forward for me positively within the aspects of my career and all that other jazz. And I obviously like what I do here with my channel and with Barbell Crew. And I wanted to talk today about you guys especially, not myself to be honest, but that's some background because I've been missing from the YouTubes. But what I really wanted to say was, although that I have a small following, either on Instagram, YouTube, in comparison to, you know, anybody else, I feel that the people that I have impacted, the people that I have made an impact on have changed their way of thinking for the better. And it's really staggering to me that, like, a lot of you guys approach me on a day-to-day basis wherever I go and tell me that I've, you know, motivated you to do this or motivated you to do that. And that's exactly why I do it. Like, for the past 3.5 years since I started Barbell Crew, that's exactly what I wanted to do. And you see a lot of people who have jobs that help others and motivate others, providing a service of some sort, gain the most happiness out of their lives. And it's not about money, you know what I mean? Like, I have a well-paying job and I have this and I have that, but what makes me happy is really getting you guys out there and doing your thing, you know what I mean? And that's why I make this content the way I do, to evoke an emotion in you guys and apply some form of mental challenge, not just a physical challenge, which powerlifting is. You guys need to apply yourself fully in terms of educating yourself, in terms of mentally preparing yourself, in terms of physically pushing yourself. It's a lot more than just a physical thing. And this doesn't just go for powerlifting, it goes for any sport that you do, depending on the circumstances that you're in. So let's say if you do rugby, let's say if you do taekwondo, if you do, you know, weightlifting, if you do bodybuilding, they all require those three things. And if I can evoke emotion, I know how much it's pushed me. So if I can get another person to do that for others, it just makes a ripple effect and everybody starts motivating each other. And it's not very overt in the way that I do things, but that's how it adds up to me. Doing Barbell Crew, creating a community that really resonates with those who have been in difficult times. I know that a lot of my content doesn't sit well with everybody, and that's okay. I know the people out there who don't really have much and they have challenges that they're faced in their lives and they need somewhere to turn to, see my content of an outlet to really kind of conceptualize how they're feeling. And it makes me happy that I can provide that type of service to someone. And I thank you guys for being on my journey so far, and I know it's nowhere near ending, but as it continues and unfolds, you guys are the reason why I do what I do. Without you guys, why would I be making videos? You know what I mean? Like, it wouldn't make no sense. And obviously, I don't have much of a following to make any money of it. And I just really enjoy that type of recognition for pushing you guys. When people tell me, like I said before, Kevin, you're so good at this, that doesn't do it for me. Like, that does nothing for me. And I hopefully you guys feel the same way. You don't want to be recognized for the things that, you know, are very superficial about you, but the changes that you make in others, that should make you feel really good about yourself, because that's how you change not the world, but the landscape of a sport, the landscape of a workplace. It changes more than just you. Try to affect others in a positive way. That's just my message for today.
What's up, guys? It's Kay Bowie. Thank you again for tuning in to Strong Shredded. If you're returning, and welcome to those who are new here. And today is just my highlight deadlift session from a couple of weeks of doing more specificity, but I did throw in some squats today which have failed to work properly, so I'm not going to include them in the video. But I did squat with reps, and I believe this is my second session back. My first session back the other week, I did sleeves, and today I did reps up to 210 for 3 reps after deadlifting. So I was completely knackered by the end of it, but the conditions of my deadlifting have been under a lot of work outside of the gym. Been doing 10-hour, 15-hour shifts. Did a 15-hour shift the night before this workout, and 10 hours during the day before the actual workout itself. So I understand a lot of people have lives outside of the gym, and maybe labor intensive or long hours, it's still possible to get those hard workouts in if you really believe it, because I'm completely gone mentally in this video. But I really know how to switch on, because the work ethic that I learn at work plus the experience that I have as a lifter pushes me through these workouts, and I know what's safe and what's not. So it's a nice thing to have a lot of experience under your belt, and that's why coaches are there. And I'm currently not coaching anymore. I'm coaching a few people who've been under me for a long time, but that's about it. And yeah, there's a highlight session where I do 280 for 5 after 300 for 2, which is better than my recent workouts where I do 300 for a few singles and 260 for a few reps in sets. As for Powerlifting Australia and the affiliation of the IPF, that's done. It's been completely excluded, therefore Australia is no longer part of the International Powerlifting Federation, which is not a good thing, because that was my goal to get to Worlds in 2018 in Calgary, Canada. So I really needed to make a decision where I get to compete at least in 2018 against somewhat decent lifters and really enjoy myself, because that's all the IPF ever gave me, or sorry, not the IPF, Powerlifting Australia ever gave me, a platform to compete against other lifters of a high caliber, and that's about it. Federations like that really just take from you and don't really give back. And if anybody's planning on staying in the in Powerlifting Australia, make the decision for yourself, because they only made decisions for themselves. That's all I have to say, guys. Thanks for watching. Be strong, be notorious, be barbell crew. Peace.
This is for a world record. He's got it. What do they say?